Disappointing. I don't know if you guys think this class is a joke, but symbiotic relationships are really important. Hopefully, you guys are going to knock it out of the park with your presentations, because that might give you an opportunity to bring these grades up from where they are. So you guys look at these test results. I mean, they're really bad. I don't know if you guys didn't study, but you know, the presentations you guys are going to give on symbiotic relationships is going to be really important, and I hope you guys are preparing, because if you look at those tests, and you cannot take a makeup test, I'm sorry, you can make corrections, and I might bring your grade up slightly, but, you know, a 53 on this test is highly unacceptable, and tomorrow's the day you have the chance to maybe bring this grade up a little bit. You know, some higher grades in these presentations that we've started and we're going to continue. So if everybody could do me a favor, and we're going to take the rest of this class to work on our presentations for those of you that haven't presented yet. So if you guys want to take out your laptops and get to work, this time will be yours. I'm available if you have any questions, any concerns. I think the parameters of the presentations are pretty clear, so let's get to it.
Thank you. turn.
Jack, thank you for your presentation. Maybe next time you want to spell check before you present. Thanks a lot. And I guess we'll be calling up Ryan next. Oh, wait, Ryan's not here. How about Dylan? Is Dylan here tonight?
No, they're not coming tonight, big game.
No Dylan?
Okay.
All right, then. I guess that means, Jake, you're up. You are next. I hope we have something special in store. Introductory slide and a concluding slide? Are you unprepared? Seriously, Jake, are you unprepared?
There were four slides there yesterday.
Oh yeah, I'm sure there were. I saw you yesterday and how hard you were working over there with your friends.
I was working.
On what? I mean,
on this.
Thanks for listening and welcome to Mutualism. You don't have anything.
I can go check my computer.
No, you don't get another chance at this. Was it good enough for you? I don't know.
I mean, I can go check my computer.
No, I think what you can do is you can go sit down. And, I mean, with your test yesterday, this is what you are doing. Now you're making a joke of things? Like, seriously, you only have two slides?
There were more slides.
You did an introductory slide and a concluding slide. That's it? But all the time that I gave you yesterday? I don't know what to tell you other than maybe if you want to talk about this after class, we can do so, but this is unacceptable, and why don't you just go back and sit down with all your buds back there, and yeah, why don't you just go back to your seat, because that was a joke. Next will be Francis. Francis, you will be next. Mark, what up?
Let me see if you're testing. Give me that back.
Come on.
You think it's funny, huh? My presentation?
No.
Look at this.
Mom, of course so bad. What the fuck you got off of that?
Let's see what he's talking
about.
Yeah, there's nothing. You just right there.
What's your plan?
I saw it. He was texting the lady. What are you doing? You were doing something. I know you was doing something.
I'm a sucker.
Mark.
Just who do I want to talk to?
So I actually have something I want to share with you.
You bet you do.
What?
Just go on. Go on, Mark.
I was at school and I saw this flyer with this number on it, and it was like a AI computer thing, and I started texting it.
A computer on campus?
Yeah, there was a flyer on campus, and you know, I was texting you one day and it just, you know, said it wanted to help.
Help how?
I don't know, I just offered to help. It would, you know, change my science grade from a 81 to like a 94
Mark,
or something.
Stop there. If this is some type of elaborate way to defend Mr. Watson, I want you to stop right now.
What?
Mark, the reason I was interested in seeing you was we just had to let Mr. Watson go. In fact, I just confirmed with our IT department that Mr. Watson was changing your grade specifically, and only your grade. And now you're walking in my office and saying it was a computer?
Exactly. It wasn't Mr. Watson who changed the grades. It was the AI.
Do you have any proof of these messages?
Yeah, I have proof. I'm here. If you just, you know, scroll up, you can see everything.
Hey computer, is there any way you can hack my grade? I'm not authorized to do so. Well, how do I authorize you to do so? Anyway, you can release the video of Jack presenting?
Well, no. The AI can change the messages at any moment.
Mr. Watson is on my nerves. Anyway, can you make it seem like he changed my grades?
That's exactly what it just did. I mean, I don't know.
Mark, am I reading this right? You're telling me that this computer hacked your grades. Yet what I'm reading is that you told it to do so.
I mean, I don't know how else to explain it. It's just changing the messages right now.
So now this mystery computer is just changing messages all across campus, your grades, anything.
No, yeah, it's changed the messages multiple times before. I mean, it's doing it now to get back at me.
To get back at you?
For not wanting to be its friend.
Mark, I thought I heard it all, buddy.
Look, you may not believe those messages or not, you may not believe me, but that computer can be accessed to anybody on this campus. I mean, you have a serious problem here.
Major problem? Mark, we have over 600 students on this campus who are carrying over a 4.1 GPA. In fact, we have the highest graduation rate in the entire interim. I have not run into a single other occurrence or a complaint with this computer. If I had, I doubt it would be for changing grades, quite frankly. Because that's the last thing the majority of our kids need. And now you come into my office and show me evidence that it wasn't Mr. Watson who changed the grade, but it was in fact you who changed the grades.
Well, no, I actually just can't hack my grades. I don't even know how to. I can't do that.
Your texts here clearly show you taking advantage of a computer system and using it to hack your grades. And then you're going to try to cover up the mistake by saying the computer was developed by us?
Yeah, the computer is on campus.
It's right here.
No, it's being...
Do you want to dig a bigger hole for yourself? At this school, we have a zero-tolerance policy against cheating. And beyond that, I now am in the unenviable position of having to explain this to students and faculty that you've affected more. Mark, I'm sorry, but I just cannot see a scenario where you're still a student here at Malvern Prep.